Over 150 Texan hospital staff have been laid off or quit after refusing to get the COVID jab. Most are taking legal action, but it's led to a debate about whether employees can be forced to get inoculated.
Discussions with her employer made no difference in the end. Jennifer Bridges has just learned that she's lost her job as a nurse. The reason? She refused to be vaccinated against COVID-19.
And they created a protocol saying we had to take the COVID vaccine by June 7th, or we'd be on a two-week unpaid suspension leading into termination. And yesterday, June 21st, was our last day of that unpaid suspension. So today, I just got my phone call stating, since I did not choose to take the shot, I will be terminated as of today.
Jennifer is one of over 150 employees at Houston Methodist Hospital who have either resigned or been fired after refusing to get vaccinated. The hospital says the jab is safe and essential to protect staff and patients. But sacked employees claim the vaccine is experimental.
We want the public to see that we should not have lost our jobs and that Methodist is not properly giving people informed consent or talking about adverse reactions. We want the public to be properly informed of this shot before they take it themselves.
Plenty of Americans have already received the jab. 150 million of them are now fully vaccinated against COVID-19. However, uptake is slowing. Vaccine skepticism is widespread, particularly in rural areas. The U.S. government insists the approved vaccines are safe, and getting more people jabbed is essential to prevent new strains of coronavirus taking hold.
The Delta variant is currently the greatest threat in the U.S. to our attempt to eliminate COVID-19. Good news, our vaccines are effective against the Delta variant. Conclusion, we have the tools, so let's use them and crush the outbreak.
Back in Texas, a judge dismissed a lawsuit against Houston Methodist Hospital despite protests. Texan law only protects staff if they refuse to commit a crime. The judge criticized Jennifer Bridges for comparing compulsory jabs to medical experiments during the Holocaust. She and her fellow employees now hope to take their case to the Supreme Court.
Big U.S. banks are also demanding staff get vaccinated. Otherwise, they'll be banned from the office. That's the policy at Morgan Stanley, J.P. Morgan and Goldman Sachs. Those who haven't had the jab will have to work remotely. That could put their jobs at risk, as many top executives have said they want everyone back in the office. Well, Amanda Lennon is a specialist in employment law and is against compulsory vaccination at work. Charlie Mullins runs the UK's biggest independent service and maintenance company and has told applicants no jab, no job. Charlie, starting with you, shouldn't it be our own choice?
It is your own choice. We're saying that anybody that wants to come to work for us, we're not taking anybody on as from September that hasn't had the jab. I mean, as an employer, I have a responsibility to protect our staff and their customers. That's what we're doing. We're not the bad guys here. This is all about safety and about people's lives. And, you know, I have to say it, the workforce are very, very happy at the moment that we're putting this in place. And they'd be more unhappy if I allow people into the workplace that haven't had the jab.
But let me play devil's advocate. Forcing job applicants to get the shot with millions around the world out of work, fighting for their livelihoods right now.
I think you're taking it away from what we're talking about. I mean, what we're talking about is asking somebody to have the jab on people's safety that come to work where many other people in there and going in customers' houses. I mean, you're taking it out of proportion and you know, what we're doing, we're not the bad guys here. We're looking after employees, we're looking after customers, we're looking after their families, making sure that they're in a safe working environment. And as I say, our staff are very, very pleased at what we're putting in place.
I understand the safety issue at stake here. Amanda, what are the legalities of making staff get vaccinated?
So firstly, I just want to clarify, I'm not against employers putting in place vaccination policies, but from my perspective, at this stage, vaccinations aren't mandatory. The government has not mandated vaccines. So at this point in time, it's very difficult for employers to take such a broad brush approach. Yes, they do have an obligation to look after their employees' health and safety, and certainly offering a vaccine policy is something that could be looked at as part of that. However, I think we need to be sensitive to the fact that lots of people still don't want to take the vaccine. And whilst I understand Mr. Mullin's perspective and in relation to the industry that he's in and his workers going into people's homes, we can't dismiss the other side of that, which is that people are nervous still. Some people are about taking the vaccine. And actually, it will be interesting to see how case law develops in this area. It's very new. So I'm expecting this to be a point of legal debate in the very near future, actually.
Well, back
it could
to,
be said that...
I just wanted to bring us back to the healthcare workers. How is their vaccine requirement any different to other mandates like getting an annual flu shot or wearing hairnets or other immunisations?
Well, it may be that is how things progress, but at this point in time, from my perspective, we can't just go ahead with a broad vaccine policy when it is very possible in the UK, certainly, that refusing to take the vaccine, if that's seen as a philosophical belief or even a religious belief, that could be protected under the Equality Act, and therefore to force people in that situation to take the vaccine could amount to disability discrimination.
How do you see it, Charlie, if you have applicants who are wanting to get a job at your company and because of religious beliefs or perhaps conditions that they already have and they're not able to actually get vaccinated, you know, this puts them out of the labour market as far as applying for a job at your company goes?
Certainly, as far as Pimlico plumbers go, it also puts them out of, you know, being able to socialise, being able to meet family, being able to travel. We have to do something. We've been about this epidemic for 18 months. We're not going anywhere. I mean, even your own Chancellor, Angela Merkel, is saying that she doesn't want anyone coming in from the EU that's not had the vaccine, or they've got to do the quarantine for 14 days. There's nothing wrong with that. This is about safety. It's the most important thing going on in the world at the moment, is getting the economy going, getting things back to normal, and letting people get on with their life. I mean, vaccination isn't the enemy. It's actually the only thing we've got that we're being told could help us. And as I say, I'll go back to what I'm saying. I will not put my staff or my customer at risk by allowing people to work for me that have not had the vaccination. If they don't want to take it or they've got medical reasons, then, you know, unfortunately, they can't work for us. And I really feel they're not going to be able to move around and sort of get into these places. But that's their choice. If they want to sit at home and not get involved with everything, I can't do nothing about that. But I'm not going to put customers and staff at risk, all because there's a few people out there, very minority, that either don't want to do it or generally, if they've got a medical reason, that's got to be looked at in a separate issue. When you go to certain countries, you've got to have a vaccine. You're not allowed in there. I mean, nobody objects to that. When if you want to be a pilot, you've got to have a medical. If you join the army, you've got to have a medical. Nobody objects to that. You know, we're not actually being the enemy here. I mean, I think years ago in the Black Plague or something, they used to put a cross on your door and leave you in there to die. We're saying to somebody, that's not going to happen. What we're doing is just offering you a jab to get through this situation.
OK, Charlie Mullins there, the owner of a big business in the UK. Amanda Lennon talking to us about the legalities involved in forcing workers to get vaccinated. Thank you to both of you. Thanks for being on the show today.
Thank you.
Thank you.